indicating that the sleep mode has triggered. Hello, and in this video, I'm going to be covering the Watchdog Timer. The schematic for this tutorial is exactly the same as the previous one with the comparator and interrupt-based programming. So the Watchdog Timer is an independent timer from the PIC itself. It does not use any of the peripherals and is independent of your sleep mode. It only requires the internal oscillator to be running. The nominal period of the Watchdog Timer is 4 milliseconds with the same stability as the internal oscillator. Now the Watchdog Timer is multiplied by a 16-bit postscaler. And any output from the Watchdog Timer postscaler is selected by a multiplexer controlled by the configuration register H2. We have a maximum of 131.072 seconds, which is 2.8 minutes for a period of the Watchdog Time reset. Any sleep instruction we send or clear Watchdog Timer instruction we send will reset the Watchdog Timer's counter. The Watchdog Timer is mainly used to wake the microcontroller from sleep. Now here we have a functional diagram of the Watchdog Timer. You see it first gets divided by 128, and then it goes to the programmable prescaler, which you preset with the configuration bits. Then we have the preset change. It's also reset if you have a clock failure or a clock source change. Here you can see it comes from sleep mode. As soon as it overflows, which is referred to as the reset, it wakes up from any power manage mode it is currently in. Then next we have the WDT con register or Watchdog Timer control register, and it has a single bit in it, which is bit 0. Which is referred to as the software Watchdog Timer enable control bit. If it's 1, turn on the Watchdog Timer. If it's 0, turn off the Watchdog Timer. Now we are not going to use this bit, since this bit has no effect when WD10 is enabled, which I am going to enable via the configuration bits. Then we have the configuration register too high, which controls the postscaler of the Watchdog Timer. I'm going to use a 1 to 64 postscaler for about a 1 second timing. And then we have the watchdog enable bit. If it's 1, enable the bit. If it's 0, disable the bit. Now this is a bit different in code, but we'll cover that when we get there. Now we have a block diagram of how the watchdog timer works in the oscillator configuration chapter of the datasheet. So we first have our oscillator, which is an 8 MHz source, and then it can output a 31 kHz internal RC output. And that directly clocks the watchdog timer. So this gives you the ability to have your CPU powered down and your peripherals powered down while the watchdog timer is running in the background. Okay, now let's look at the timings of the watchdog timer. So the watchdog timer's period starts at 4 milliseconds and ends at 131.072 seconds. Now what I'm going to use is a postscaler of 64 to give me an approximate of 1 second. Now let's have a look at the code. Okay, now the code I'm using is the exact same code from the last video with minor modifications. Now to enable the watchdog timer, we go to the conbits.h folder. We open up the memory views and we go to configuration bits. Now in configuration bits, all we need to do is turn the watchdog timer on in this tab, and then we set the watchdog timer's prescaler to 64, or you can go to the other side and then use the drop-down menu, which corresponds better to the datasheet. The watchdog timer is enabled and it's set to a 1 to 64 postscaler. And then you can click generate code to output. And then we just look for the watchdog timer configurations, which is over here. So when you set configuration bits, it's not exactly like setting a register. Like you can see, the watchdog timer enable is equals to on. And then the postscaler is set to the value of 64, so more human readable. Now to the main code, I still have the sleep mode set to be in the RC state, where your CPU is off, but your peripherals are running in the background. And the next thing I do is I disable timer 2 because it is not necessary anymore to trigger the ADC reads. The main problem for using the watchdog timer is I couldn't use the timer because the timer only had a maximum of 1 millisecond intervals for its interrupts. So it's much more useful to use it like I'm using it for every second. And then another major change is your delay functions turn from, say, underscore underscore delay MS to delay WDT, which is delay watchdog timer. If you use the standard delay, you can't get away with it with short periods, but long periods like this for 2 seconds just hangs the CPU and it doesn't want to go anywhere. I was continuously getting stuck at this point. And you can see timer 2 is off, and then the main change here in the main loop is if there's no ADC data from the interrupt, start an ADC read. And then we have ADC done, which just prints out the value of the ADC and then just a LED toggling on and off to show the intervals at which the code is running. And then we stop the timer 2 from going on. Now the other things we can do is we can swap between deep sleep mode, which is idle n equals to 0, and RC idle mode, which is idle n equal to 1. But I found for my purposes it doesn't work because I'm constantly monitoring the comparator pins. And that only triggers when idle n is equal to 1. Here you can enable the deep sleep modes and check it out for yourself from the GitHub link. And then we just enter sleep mode. And then I just took away the code that runs inside the timer 2 low priority interrupt. And this code stays pretty much the same. So an execution example of this code would be, when the code starts, start an ADC read, go to RC idle mode, the ADC read triggers, goes to the main loop, sees ADC done is true, we go to the if, and then we print out the voltage value to the UART, we set ADC done as false, we toggle the LED to change from a previous state, and then sleep. And then this will wait the full 1 second for the watchdog timer to time out. And then we repeat the process as from boot, where we go ADC false, trigger a read, go to sleep, wake when ADC is done, and then print ADC value, toggle LED, go to sleep for 1 second. And then one other thing is, the comparator is continuously monitored, so if there's a trigger on the comparator, it will swap the two LEDs to indicate when the comparator is triggered. This interrupt will continuously trigger if you set between the voltage trigger values. Now let's look at the practical demonstration. Okay, now you can see the comparator is in the high state, with the red LED being on and the green LED indicating that the sleep mode has triggered. So you can see that flashing about every 1 second. When we take the comparator low, okay, now the comparator is in low state with the LED triggering every second. And now I'm going to put the voltage between the two states of the comparator, and you'll see the change in the LED, the comparator interrupt continuously waking the CPU. Now you can see the comparator in between two states. And that's a basic introduction to using the watchdog timer to wake a microcontroller from sleep. Any code that I've written will be linked on my Git. Any parts that I've used will be linked down in the description. A like, share, comment, and subscribe would be greatly appreciated. Thank you. Have a nice day.